So Carly Fiorina made some absolutely bogus claims during the CNBC debate, and she was called out for it. She was called out for it, and as a result of that, she's going to lose her shit.
You say that it unemployment among women has spiked. Let's listen to that.
It is the height of hypocrisy for Mrs. Clinton to talk about being the first woman president when every single policy she espouses and every single policy of President Obama has been demonstrably bad for women. 92% of the jobs lost during Barack Obama's first term belonged to women.
Now, according to the Washington Post fact checker, that is a recycled talking point from the Mitt Romney campaign that they've deemed as false. They say that you were using a very narrow moment in time when unemployment among women had spiked, but that since then the numbers have changed and it's a much rosier picture for women. What's your response?
Well, first of all, it's the Washington Post that said I wasn't a secretary. So from my point of view, they have no credibility, honestly. The statistics are well known. Here's another statistic, Allison, if you don't like that one. The extreme poverty rate among women is at the highest level ever recorded. The number of women living in poverty is at the highest level in 20 years. And every single policy that Hillary Clinton is now proposing, demonstrably, we have evidence that suggests it causes women to be fired, not to be hired. The record's very clear on this.
But is there newer data available that makes those numbers obsolete that you shouldn't have used the old numbers last night?
No, absolutely not. Wow. This is the same conversation we had after the last debate. Everybody came out and said I was using wrong data. No, I'm not using wrong data. The liberal media doesn't like the data. Perhaps the liberal media doesn't like the facts. The facts are clear. Women have been hit hardest by this recession and this lackluster economic recovery. That's just a fact. Women are suffering more than men. And by the way, African Americans are suffering as well. All the groups that progressives claim to be helping are being hurt in this Barack Obama term. And of course, Hillary Clinton is going to double down on every single one of these policies.
During the last debate, what people said was erroneous about what you said were about the Planned Parenthood sting videos. And that what came out afterwards was that there had been portions that had been edited. Do you change your opinion about those now?
Wow, Allison, I can't believe we're having this conversation, honestly. It's clear now, it's very clear, that Planned Parenthood is harvesting body parts, so clear that they had to announce that they no longer take compensation for it. Honestly, this has been hashed and rehashed. Is there no other issue of economic import to the middle class in the United States of America that you'd like to talk about this morning?
Okay, this really gets under my skin. Because she's outraged and she's saying, how dare you, when a CNN reporter is actually doing her goddamn job. Now, usually I go after CNN, because usually they don't do this. They don't do fact-checking, they don't do follow-up questions. This is a rare case where they are doing that, and credit to that CNN host there. And look at the response that you get from the candidates when they do fact-checking and follow-up questions. You get this entitled attitude like, ugh, gross. You're actually calling me out on my bullshit? Don't you understand how this game is played? You're the establishment media, which means I get to say whatever I want, and you can't fact-check me, or else, and if you do, I won't give you access to me anymore. So then you don't have access to a candidate running for president, and you know you want it, so perhaps you shouldn't fucking fact-check me anymore. That's the mindset. The mindset on Carly Fiorina's part is entitled. The mindset is outrage that, oh God, you're bringing up information and data, and now I have to obfuscate and talk my way out of this? I don't want to do that. Let me just act outrage instead. Carly, let me put this to you very simply. You're just wrong. You're just wrong. It's been proven that Planned Parenthood is harvesting body parts. That's what she said. No, Carly, they're not. Every single fact-checking organization has said that is not true. What happened in those so-called sting videos, we've gone over this time and time again, but people pretended to be medical researchers who were trying to get fetus parts, fetal tissue, for medical research to cure diseases, and when they discussed costs, it was all about the transportation cost because it's expensive to transport fetal tissue. So that's what was happening, but you fell for the nonsense in the videos where it was edited like crazy and they put scary music in the background to tug at your heartstrings, and you fell for it, and you really thought that Planned Parenthood is a genocidal group that's, quote, harvesting body parts. At face value, Carly, you should be, wait, that doesn't sound quite right, does it? That seems a little misleading, no? She fell right for it. And then when she gets called out on it, she doubles down. But that's what makes you a silly person. So when they say, you know, Carly, fact checkers look into this, it's not the case that 92% of the jobs lost were for women. She's like, yeah, it is. Yeah, it is. No, but see, they actually, and I read the articles on this too, by the way. They go on and on. They go get into all the details of it. And it's like, no, look, at the end of the day, the way you calculated that doesn't make sense for a variety of reasons. Number one, the second Obama took office, you started calculating, and then you stopped soon into it as opposed to continuing until today, which would change the statistics drastically as she was trying to lay out there, the host was. And Carl's like, no. No, these are facts. The liberal media doesn't like facts. Projection all day long. You don't like the facts. That's why you're doing the tap dance now. And again, this is another one where at face value, Carly, you don't go, you know, it smells funny. 92% of the jobs lost women. 92%. You don't, really? It's not like 46% thereabouts? 92? And you're like, that's gotta be true because it's against Democrats and I'm against Democrats. No, see, you're a joke. I know I said it before, I'm gonna say it again because it's true. And the fact that, you know, you have this level of outrage when you're arguing things that are patently absurd, like, for example, her claim there was, during the debate, every single policy, quote, every single policy has been demonstrably bad for women from Obama and Clinton. When you say something that absolutist, you have to think, like, oh, I'm going a little too far out on a limb here. Shouldn't I hedge a little bit? Shouldn't I say most policies or just something that sounds more reasonable? Nope. But she's a bald-faced liar. She doesn't care. She's just throw it out there and whatever. And if somebody questions her, act outraged. Oh, that's not right. So just to swiftly debunk this nonsense, if you think every single policy from Obama and Clinton has been bad for women, do yourself a favor. Call Lily Ledbetter. Ask if she agrees with you. You don't know who Lily Ledbetter is? Well, you should, because this is the first bill that Obama signed, the Lily Ledbetter Fair Pay Act, which extended the statute of limitations for cases that involved women being paid lower for doing the same jobs as men. So ask her if it's the case that every single policy has been anti-woman. Or how about ask all the Democrats who voted in favor of re-upping the Violence Against Women Act, which of course is very important and has been a cornerstone in the battle against domestic violence against women. There's a variety of provisions in the law, of course, that directly address this. There's a hotline where women can call if they're suffering from domestic violence and related issues. And just we could sit here and all day go through all the different platforms. Why don't you ask women if that's bad for them? Because you said every single policy. And Hillary Clinton pushing for paid maternity leave. What, you think women don't like that? Why don't you ask them? There's, I can speak on behalf of all women because I'm Carly Fiorina. Fuck you. No, you can't. No, you can't. Look at the polling data. Look at what people actually say. They don't agree with you, Carly, and neither do the facts.